Orion Starshoot G3 review next. Well, if you don't have time to watch the entire review and you're looking for a good entry-level Astro Cam, stop now and buy the Orion Starshoot G3. If you'd like to continue watching, I have some really good pointers and some information about my experiences with the G3 camera. Stay tuned.
The G3 arrived in a cardboard box and was well packed. It comes with a G3 camera, power cable, USB cable, owner's manual, and Orion camera studio software.
When you pick up the G3, it feels like a solid piece of hardware. The only reason I didn't give the G3 five stars was because of the cooling. I've never been able to set the G3 to one temperature and have the G3 stay at set point all night. Regulated cooling is normally found on more expensive cameras. The G3's regulated cooling does help keep the camera noise to a minimum. You know, during the night the temperatures always drop, and I found the G3 was susceptible to the ambient temperature. Upon closer look at the G3, you can see there's an auto guider port, there's the fan, there's a USB port, and the power port right here. The G3 also has a removable 1.25 inch nozzle, and that exposes the CCD chip. You can add a larger accessory like a 2-inch filter wheel or other type of 2-inch device to this camera.
Image quality. The G3 image quality is very good. First, let me show you an image of a dark frame. The dark frame helps illustrate the noise level on the G3. I have two dark frames, each at 600 second exposure. One dark taken in the winter and one dark taken in the summer. The winter dark had a cooling set point of minus 10. At the start of the imaging session, the G3 kept on track with minus 10, but as the night went on, the G3 CCD temp reached minus 20 Celsius. The second dark example was taken during the summer at plus 10 C. And in this example, the actual CCD temp was plus 9.6 C. This dark was taken early in the evening. Here's a 100% crop side-by-side comparison of the upper left corner of the dark frames at different temperatures. The one on the left is winter dark at minus 20, and the summer dark is plus 10 on the right. You'll notice that the winter dark has rounded noise points versus the summer dark at plus 10 has these longer vertical noise points. While the dark frames had some noise, the G3's regulated cooling does reduce camera noise. G3 image samples. The first one I have here is IC1396, the elephant trunk. Now, the one thing that I noticed on this image is you can see the long stars inside here. This was taken during the summer. So this is a point where the temperature of the camera was a higher temperature than a winter camera shot, and you can see that the stars are elongated. The next sample I have is NGC 1055, a galaxy that's 54 million light years from Earth. This was taken with the G3 mono camera using the Orion ED 80 millimeter triplet, and this is 20 10 minute exposures. M13 globular cluster taken with the G3 mono camera. This was taken with the Eon 120. These are all 60 second exposures, and it's 15 luminance, 15 red, 15 green, and blue filters. You can see on these short exposures the stars are very nice and round. M27 Planetary Nebula, again taken with the G3 mono camera. This was taken with the Eon 120, all 600 second exposures, and I had 10 each of the luminance red, green, and blue filters. M51 Whirlpool Galaxy. This was taken with the Eon 120, all 600 second exposures, 15 each of luminance, red, green, and blue filters. M106 Galaxy, again the camera's G3 mono, taken with the Eon 120. Now, these are all 600 second exposures, but I only have two each of the luminance, red, green, and blue. Normally I don't like to show images with just two frames. You can see the noise in this one is much greater. Ideally I like to take 15 or more frames of each filter. The Flame Nebula. This was taken with the Eon 120, all 600 second exposures. Now this is another example of not many frames. I only have five each of the red, green, and blue filters. Orion Camera Studio Software. It's nice to see Orion develop astrophotography software. During the past year, I've seen four significant upgrades to Orion Camera Studio software. The user interface is a little difficult to navigate at first, and finding the user controls aren't intuitive to find. This can be frustrating when you don't know what you're looking for, and beginners may get confused. Once you find the needed windows, camera control, and capture, things come together quickly. If for some reason you close these windows, go to View, Reset, Tools, Docking as of version 1.5. These little docking windows pull out of the user interface and you can dock them any way you'd like, but the docking feature is a little hard to use. Some people may enjoy the ability to customize their own window capturing desktop. I have an Orion filter wheel and there's no feature to integrate an Orion filter wheel. It would be nice to have the Orion filter wheel automatically change filters for the Mono G3. If you purchase a color version of the G3, then changing filters may not be a concern. Maybe a future release will include filter wheel support. Overall, Orion Camera Studio software has a great start and will help you acquire your photos. I applaud Orion for starting the development of their software. This needs further development, and the good thing is Orion seems to be making improvements. Nothing is easy in astrophotography. Be prepared to take your time and learn baby steps. Soon you'll find the G3 will become easier to use. As you get started, remember to take notes of what works for you. The Orion G3 is an excellent value. All of these advanced features are never seen at this low price. For a beginner wanting to get started, this is a great entry-level AstroCam. The Orion G3 is perfect for anyone wanting to get their feet wet in astrophotography. The value is ideal for people unsure about astrophotography as a hobby, but be warned, astrophotography is highly addictive. After you use the G3 for a while, you will become well versed in astrophotography. The Orion G3 is a very good AstroCam. There are some needed improvements, but nothing that will stop you from enjoying the great value of Orion's G3 camera. The G3 doesn't come with a protective travel case, but we found an inexpensive solution that works very well. My wife found this London, Soho, New York beauty case at Walmart, and we picked up some foam and material to cover it. And it works very well to hold your G3 and keep it protected while you're traveling. I recommend getting a travel case like this and just making it yourself. It's about $25 in materials.
If this is the first time you're watching, I would like you to subscribe. I publish two astrophotography videos on the 1st and 15th of every month. Thanks for watching, and I hope to see you soon.